So that was just a brief break, and we are back for session two with the second link. Those that were watching the previous link, we ended it with the men's 10 kilometer race. What a race! Won by Bantan athlete from KwaZulu-Natal. Home favorite to win. As we are moving through the categories, next we have the girls, 14 years old. They will only be doing two loops. Just a quick brief here. We have 28, 55 competitors. Big field over here. Big field. Big field for field for these girls. The future also is in the youth, and these girls form part of the youth. I will be giving you guys, I'm sure I still have a little bit of time. They're about to start, but nevertheless, you will watch the start. As I start, I'm just going to say Athletic Central Northwest has got four athletes: Esther Marie, Howard, Michaela Joy, Rosita, Anshan, Skitter, and we are underway. We have Abigail Falloon. Then we have Athletics Free State with six athletes. Athletics Gauteng North also with six athletes. And Mpumalanga also with six athletes. Athletics Northwest North also with six athletes. As we watch these girls starting, I'm just going through the start list over here. Athlete Southwestern District has got one, and looks like we have an early leader. She wants to set the pace from the word go. 10.088 Athletics Val Nswaki Ramafikeng. She has taken an early lead. She is not wasting any time whatsoever. Central Gauteng Athletics also with six athletes. Eastern Province also three athletes. KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, the home favorites, with six athletes as well. Limpopo Athletics also with six athletics. And then we are concluding the list with the Western Province Athletics, Pearl Chanel Du Plessis. Now these are a lot of girls for me to read, so I do apologize for not reading all 55 names, but the list is long. I will try and give pointers as the race goes on, so that you viewers at home can know more or less what is going on. Also, to let you know about the track, this is a 2 kilometer loop. These girls will be doing two loops as they are doing 4 kilometers. They will be going from the start past us here at the commentary booth, where you see the shot of them running close on camera. They go down into the lush jungle of this course, where it is the most difficult course. If you were watching the previous live stream on the men's 10 kilometer, Adam Lipschitz and Temin Medima, very, very experienced runners in the cross-country world, they mention of how tough it actually is to run this second part of the race. And then they do eventually go up to the screen that you are seeing. They go all the way up around the scoreboard to where you see now, where then they go downhill. At the downhill, they go to the difficult and the most wet part of the track, I do believe, and from there they do make the loop. This is a big field. It is very, very well contested, and I do believe that these girls are going to put on a show. We had a lot of good races so far, and I bet my bottom dollar that this one will be just as great. Once again, we are here in day two, Athletics South Africa Cross Country Championships, day two, with the girls under 14. At a mention, just to show you, officials relaxing, wind picking up a little bit, but they are waiting for the girls to come so that they can indicate the way. It is visible, but just so that they don't get lost or go off course, the girls get led by the referees. And also to mention that Athletics South Africa has only let in about 30% or a tenth of the people allowed. Adam Lipschitz, the captain of the Social Runner Club, said that if it is not COVID times, close to 4,000 people come to watch cross country, and that must be one hell of an atmosphere. As we get ready to welcome the girls coming up the hill, it is quite something. I mean, we had action in the men's 10 kilometer, and we're going to get action here. COVID protocols are being adhered to. This event is well run. And if you have just joined us, please don't forget to share, to tell your friends, your family members, to watch your friends or your family members running on the YouTube page of ASA, as well as the Athletics South Africa webpage. And as you can see, the girls have come up the hill, where it's the toughest part of the track. The leader is not anymore the girl from Athletics Transkei. Now we have the leader, which is running in the colors of Athletics Northwest North, and her name is Omawatla Dikao. Then she is followed by a bunch of AGN runners, as well as Mpumalanga runner over there. If I could just see a few names: 553, 576. 553 is Lisa de Jager, Athletics Gauteng North. 476, I also saw over there, is Elisna LaRue. So we are underway. It is not such a big gap as we saw, but these girls are running. They are coming. You see another Athletics Gauteng North, but the number 501 goes for Janssen Pinar. So they are running. We see there another athlete from with bib number 299, Mika Louise Brits from Athletics Free State. Another athlete from Athletics Free State, 347, Andrea Steinberg, and 359, Carissa van Rooyen, Athletics Free State. We have an athlete from Eastern Cape Athletics. So the provinces are represented in numbers over here. In that momentary pause, I was trying to look very quickly for the numbers. So the provinces are well represented here at this national championships for the girls and the 14 4-kilometer race. This is not an easy course at all. I've walked it. I'm glad I did not run it. I was walking because there are quite a lot of blind spots on this track, because the second part, I mean the first part, is about give or take 300 or 400 meters, and then they go into the jungle, and then that part of the course has a lot, and I mean a lot of blind spots. So we could not get cameras onto those spots so that you could see how thick and how difficult that part of the race is. But these girls are doing well. As we also see here, we're going to see the winners coming in for their first loop, and in the lead now is the girl from Central Gauteng Athletics, and she goes by number 1279. 1279 is Luandi Skitter. Oh, I beg your pardon, that is Limpopo Athletics. No, sorry, 1279, I got lost there, is Kiona Robinson from Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by a couple of Athletics Gauteng North athletes. And then there we have the diminutive figure of the girl that was in the lead from Athletics Central Gauteng North, that goes by the name of Omawatla Dikao. As the girls are coming in, you can see that the girl from Central Gauteng Athletics is in the lead. The lead is not big, as I can see them come by me, but first and second are starting to detach themselves from the group. And these girls form the top half of this lead group. The girl from Athletics Mpumalanga 698. Let me just get number 698. Sheba Sitole from Athletics in Mpumalanga is part of that lead group. As we can see here, we're going to see a whole lot of runners that are in the middle of the group. Like I said, a big, big group. Girls, the girls here are 55 participants, and they're going at it. They are not giving up. There are top places up for grabs. There are team places up for grabs. And then just the importance of competition and not giving up is a great, great value to have. There's a lot of determination in these girls' faces, and everyone at home watching should be really, really proud of these girls. As we continue to escort these girls, I do believe that now we're getting to the bottom of the group, as they are finishing. This is the last loop, so we have to keep our eyes open on these girls as they make their way down to the lush jungle. It is lush. I will have to show some pictures to the guy that's come to help me over here in the commentary, and because he hasn't run the course, he didn't feel the cold of yesterday. He still laughs at me. The weather is so nice. I am in my t-shirt still, and I just would like to point out that the wind comes and goes, but as long as the sun is shining, we are not in trouble. If we get cloud cover, we are in trouble. But you see the girls here making their way down. We have the Athletics Val Triangle, Athletics in Mpumalanga. The girl that we see with 10.98. 10.98 is Nomthandazo Tikwayo from Athletics Val Triangle. We see a number 200 as she's making her way to the jungle. Number 200 is Michaela Joy Rossitia from Athletics Central Northwest. Like I said, please, there's still a whole lot more action to come. Don't forget to tune in to the Athletics South Africa webpage, or watch on YouTube on the ASA page. The action is there. We are live streaming. We are commentating. We are trying to bring you all the action so that you can see. And you can see here we have the girl, group number 861. And 861, she is 861, she is from Athletics Northwest North, Haley van der Berg. The vibe, it is quite a vibe over here. The sound is pumping. The spectators that came to watch the men's 10 kilometers stayed to watch the girls, and probably also to watch later on the senior men and senior women 4 kilometer, which I believe is going to be such an exciting race. And then to finish it off, we're going to have the women and the men under 23. We might get a change in program, and if that does happen, we will notify you. Maybe the women and the men under 23 will run before the senior men and the senior women, but we will notify you. As we see these girls coming in, we are getting ready to welcome them on the tough part of the track. As soon as they start getting to that uphill that I mentioned, as you see them over here, now the lead is being held by still the girl from Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by Athletics Gauteng North. Oh no! Athletics Gauteng North is now taking the lead. Number 476. Number 476 is Ari Kruger. 453 is Lisa de Jager. And 501 is Jansen Pienaar. Those are the top three. Looks like the girl from Central Gauteng Athletics did drop off. We could see a clean sweep in the girls under 14, 4 kilometers. Maybe the girl from Central Gauteng Athletics might make a move and snatch the bronze medal, but Keona Robinson is there in fourth place, busy contesting for that bronze medal. I do believe it's going to be a fight for the line, so we have to keep our eyes open for these girls as they're making their way to the finish line. Give or take 700 to 800 meters from where they are. Now they do make their way down quite a steep downhill where they get to the wet part of the track. Past that white board, they do go down past the wet part of the track and then onto the finish line. As we get ready to welcome our winners, I just want to show the girls that are on the last bit of running. These girls are running really, really well. The girls are coming in for the finish and I will bring that action. I'm actually really, really excited to see who is in the lead. If the girl from Central Gauteng Athletics, Kiona Robinson, is going to get the third spot or not. But we are ready. We are ready. 14:35 for this 4 kilometers. They are running really, really well. Soon we will bring you action on the finish line, as there is a tape for the finish line and they put it out for these girls as they're about to cross the finish line. But before that, you can see the girls coming in for the last 700, or like I say, 600, 700 meters of running before they finish. It is actually quite something to see the development in the youth in the under 14 girls. And we will see now the officials starting to put out the tape for the girl to come, and the gold medals is on her way. We are going to get the gold medals. 15 minutes 21, 15 minutes 22, 23 24, unofficial time, but here they are, ladies and gentlemen. So let us see who is in the lead. It is Athletics Gauteng North 476. Elry Kruger is your champion for the girls under 14, 4 kilometers, followed by her teammate 453, Lizard De Jager, also Athletics Gauteng North. And then we're going to have a clean sweep in the girls under 14 by Athletics Gauteng North, and third place going to Janssen Pienaar, Athletics Gauteng North. And then number four, and just missing out on the medal, is 12.79 from Central Gauteng Athletics, Kiona Robinson. Those are your top four. Those are your top places. As we welcome the girls, we're going to welcome these girls coming in. We're going to welcome these girls coming in so that we can get a shot maybe of the under 14s, of the top 10 of these under 14 girls that ran the 4 kilometers. But congratulations to these girls. Congratulations on Athletics Gauteng North on a top sweep. On a top sweep. So really, really, really well done. And as we can see, like you said, top places are gone. Team placing is also up for grabs. But there are still girls running. There are still girls coming in for their final runs. There's girls coming on the uphill. 8861 over here, being represented by Hayley van der Berg, Athletics Northwest North, and she is determined to finish. And this is good to see. From really, really young, they're starting to get very persistent, very determined, and getting very, very good values that will definitely aid them later in life. So all these girls that are running and that are finishing and not giving up, congratulations to those girls. As we go to the finish line, you can see how tired these girls are and how tough this race was. So girls are coming in. Those of you that have just joined us, this was the end of the girls under 14. The girls under 14 was won by Elry Kruger, if I'm not mistaken, followed by Lisa De Jager, and then it was a clean sweep with I do not want to give the wrong placings here on live, but it was a clean sweep by Athletics Gauteng North. As we see these girls coming in, you can see it was tough. We have a girl lying on the floor. She gave it her all. This is what it's about. You have to give it your all. As we can see, we see this girl. She's also giving it her all. She is not giving up. She looked behind her to see who else was coming. Still, the competitive spirit in these girls is strong, which is good to see. And we can see there that these girls gave it their all. 716 and 62. 716 is Athletics in Mpumalanga, Petra Vasnar. And number 62 is from KwaZulu Natal Athletics, and that goes to Rhys Ratgeveer. I do apologize if I mispronounce their surnames. But well done to these girls. They are determined. They showed guts. Those that are finishing, you could see still a sprint to the line, not giving up. Number 1400 over there is by the girl from Eastern Province Athletics, Marne Kuhn. So well done to her. 1100 over here from Athletics Valtra Angle, Caitlin van Veek. So the girls are coming, they're not giving up, they gave it their all. Tough conditions yesterday, I do believe, because it's more or less, how can I put it? Hotter than yesterday. The wind is there and it's not there sometimes, but these girls have done really, really well. While we follow the girls coming in, I'm just going to show you feed of the boys warming up and lining up as the judges do their final check. These are the boys that are warming up and they are getting ready. Final checks, photos being taken. It is quite a vibe up there. And if you haven't tuned in, and if you have people that haven't tuned in, let them know so that they can tune in. And while you're tuning in, please like, subscribe, get onto the pages, get onto the social media platforms of Athletics South Africa. You know, subscribe to the YouTube page so that you don't miss content that they put out. I mean, these championships were close to not happening, and then they did happen with day one happening and day two happening. Day one happening from girls under 8, under 9, under 10, under 11, under 12 and under 13, same to the boys category all the way down from under 8 to under 9. And now we're here with day two, where we go girls under 14, girls and boys under 14, girls and boys under 15, girls and boys under 16, girls and boys under 17, under 23 men and women, senior women, senior men, 4 kilometers. And then previous to this YouTube link, we had the junior and senior women 6 and 10 kilometers, and then the junior men and senior men 8 and 10 kilometers. And then the first race of the day at 7:30 today was by the masters category, masters men 35 to 49 age group, followed by the woman 35 to 49 age group. And as I do believe the girls are mostly done, we are going to go to the boys, where we will wait to see if they have gone through their final check and they are ready to go. The boys under 14 are going to start in give or take 8 minutes, so we might have a few girls coming in. Let's see if we can see a few more girls coming in before I switch to the boys. And as you can see, the wind is picking up. There's our cameras taking the flag of the Republic of South Africa. So the wind is picking up, but the sun is shining. As long as the sun is shining, it was not as cold as yesterday. As I mentioned in the previous live stream, Nolo was busy laughing at me because I was shivering. He heard I was shivering yesterday, but yesterday was really, really cold. People tell me it might have been 14 or 15. I say, no ways, it was 8 degrees. That's how I felt. But we are here at the cross-country championships on day 2, held by Athletics South Africa. And so far, we've been spoiled by all the amazing performances that we are getting.
067,
I do believe that official results are on the Athletics South Africa webpage, and I also do believe that there were results that that were pending amendment, and those are now officially launched on the ASA website. And this is really good. If you want to see the results, please go there. If you're in the area and you're lucky to come in, please don't forget to wear your mask, sanitize, because we are adhering to the COVID-19 protocol. Athletics South Africa is strict on the rules. No one is allowed to be without masks. The competitors, some of them are running in masks. They are being conscious that the pandemic is still out there. There are, I'm sure, parents that have been vaccinated. Some of us have been vaccinated, so irrespective of the vaccine or not, everyone is being cautious and everything is being adhered to. The boys, I'm sure, are going through their life, their final checks. As you can see, the judges are going there on their final checks for Central Gauteng Athletics, and we will be getting ready to go with the boys very, very shortly. Ladies and gentlemen, I will be back with the boys under 14, 4-kilometer race, as I believe most of the girls are done. The wind is picking up. You can see now the banners are blowing, but like I said, the sun is shining. Final check is being done. More or less 5 minutes to go until the boys under 14 are going to start. The boys under 14, let me give you a quick brief, are only going to do the 4 kilometers, so that's two loops of the track. And I believe this is also going to be another fast race. If you only tuned in now, welcome to the Athletics South Africa Cross Country Championships 2021. As we wait for the boys under 14, I will be reading out the names for the boys under 14. We also have a lot of participants. We have 60 participants. Maybe I'll just read out the provinces. Athletics Central Northwest is being represented by 6 athletes. Athletics Free State has brought 5 athletes. Athletics Gauteng North has brought 6 athletes. Athletics Mpumalanga has also brought 6 athletes. Athletics Gauteng North has brought Northwest North has brought 6 athletes as well. We do have good representation from Athletics Southwestern District. We have only one representation from Athletics Transkei. Athletics Vaal Triangle, there's only 4 guys. Boland Athletics is only being represented by 2 athletes. Central Gauteng Athletics is being represented by 6 athletes. I do have a feeling that the maximum athletes that a province can send is 6. Otherwise, I do believe that provinces would send more athletes, as the boys and the girls do love to run. Running is joyful. Eastern Province is only being represented by 1 athlete. KwaZulu-Natal, the home favorites, as I like to call them, are being represented by 6 athletes. Limpopo Athletics also being represented by 6 athletes. And then we have 2 athletes by Western Province Athletics. And I do believe, ladies and gentlemen, that this category of the boys under 14 is the biggest category. So we might take a while until they get going. And as I'm going through my list, I do see that this category is not the biggest. I will say the number as soon as that number comes up, but as I go through the list, the numbers for the younger generation, this will be the boys under 15 and girls under 16, is very, very big, and this is really, really good. As we get ready for the start of the boys under 14 4 kilometer cross-country race. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to let those ones that are not watching to subscribe to YouTube page so that they can watch all the live action that is being live streamed by Athletics South Africa, as well as watch on the Athletics South Africa website, where I am sure there will be something taken to Facebook on their page, on their channel, on all the social media platforms. So pay attention, and when you are there, don't be shy, like, subscribe, so that you don't miss a thing. Let's get ready for the start of the boys under 14. Boys under 14 ready to start, all of them with their watches ready to start. Taking time is really, really important, and they will be making sure they get the best position that they can. Look at the vast number of boys. Look at the vast number of boys running here. They want to run and get good position, because I will try and show you the part of the track that it funnels out as they get to the jungle. But as they come past me here on the commentating booth, you can see these boys going at it, jockeying for position. They run together in their provinces, of course. Like I said, single places up for grabs, but as well as team places are up for grabs. As I said, they get to position so that when they get to the end, before they go down, it funnels out as they get to the jungle. You can see they're not in such a big group. They do go down, only one or two or three next to each other, instead of four or five that we are used to. But from there, they do make their way. They will make their way eventually to the uphill. We cannot get you part of the jungle route, because there's a lot of blind spots, and we cannot get our cameras over there. And it's actually very, very difficult even to bring a bike to film this cross country because of this section that you see before we come here to the uphill. As they make their way to the uphill, they will go to the uphill where they will run, and then they will go across over here behind the white scoreboard that will be on camera when they go past over there. And then we will send you all the action. So while we wait for the boys, you can see everyone is relaxed. We have a bit of support. KwaZulu-Natal Athletics tent, where the athletes will be warming up. You can see everyone wearing masks. These are the medics. They're wearing gloves. Congratulations to the medics, as they have been doing a great, great job. So far as I know, people not finishing the race. There's only been two people, and this happened in the senior woman. So we have all the action. We have the action for you. So, ladies and gentlemen, we must get ready to show you what is been happening. You see there, the spectators, they are happy, they are jolly, they are wearing masks, they are in short sleeves. That can say that it is warmer than yesterday. And then as you can see, we are waiting for these boys to come up the hill, where it is the toughest part of the track. And as I mentioned, I had a very experienced long distance runner here by the name Adam Lipschitz, also known as the Social Runner Club Captain. The Social Runner Club Captain is forever present in these activities, especially in his home province, where he likes to support. He is a very, very big supporter of the event, and he commentated along with Temba Madima, and they did a pretty good job in the men's 10 kilometers. That race was very, very, very furious, won by KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. So gold medal in the senior men 10 kilometer going to the home favorite. these boys are running in a little bit of cooler conditions, and as you can see them coming up, and then they come thick and fast. But we can have here the leader so far, number 1346 is by Athletics Central Northwest, Neo Motai Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by number 997, that's Athletics Southwestern Districts, Danile Willemse also there in the mix, Athletics Gauteng North 549 goes to the athlete Rico Kutzer. So that's your top three, and they are running, and then top four and top five are 16 and 15, and that 16105, and that goes to, if I am not mistaken, I will get the names, and then I will be able to let you know from where the top five will be. So these boys making up the top five are from Western Province Athletics. Those are the top five. So ladies and gentlemen, keep your eyes glued as we see them coming up here, where they will go around the whiteboard. That whiteboard they go around from there, it's more or less 600 meters give or take, and from there they do make it to the end of the track, where they will loop, because they are running 4 kilometers each. Loop is 2 kilometers. It was quite something when you watch such a frantic start in the men's 10 kilometers and you see a very, very big group. Even this big group of boys under 14, 4 kilometers, when they start, they're all bunched up, and it's nice when they come here in groups. But then they do, ladies and gentlemen, start to spread themselves out as winners start to take control, or the leaders start to take control. But quite tactical, not easy, and they're doing really well. As we can see here, the boys are coming now. The lead is still by the Central Gauteng Athletics athlete by number 13 46 Neo Motai, followed by Athletics North, Athletics Gauteng North, and that's 549 Rico Kutzer, followed by 997 from Daniel Willemse from Athletics Southwestern Districts, followed by the two boys from Western Province, that is Steve Beba and Jamel Johnson. As they come past here, you can see that the leader in this is running barefoot, the athlete from Central Gauteng Athletics, Neo Motai, barefoot, also along with the athlete in third place, 997 Daniel Willemse from Athletics Southwest District, they are barefoot. These boys are tough, ladies and gentlemen, and they are coming for their final loop. You can see the provinces here: Athletics Gauteng Northwest, Athletics Vaal Triangle, Athletics Free State. They are just coming. They are enjoying their running. Their home favorite, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, Athletics Free State in their numbers. Athletics Central Gauteng Athletics as well, Athletics Gauteng North. These boys are really, really running and doing really, really well. It is not easy, especially because they now know exactly what lies ahead of them as they're going to the most difficult part of the track. From our view over here, it is not easy, and you can see they go all the way down, they will funnel down there. The leaders will definitely make the move over there, or they now know more or less where to make a move, because they've done one loop of this track. So we will keep our eye open as they come up onto the steepest part of the course, and as for that, we see all the boys running as they are going. I do believe that it's more or less give or take 1.4 or 1.4 kilometers from that point that they go down, so they know what lies ahead. Their stopwatches are ticking. Some of them have them on their wrist, some of them have it on their hands, and yeah, we see the home favorite of KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, bib number 145 from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, and that goes to Rory Trevelvan. Rory Trevelvan, bib number 145, as he's making his way for the final loop. All guts here from these boys. They are not giving up. They are doing really, 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 really well. These boys are show guts. They will definitely beat me. Like I always say, 401 is it's too much. 400 is my limit. 401 is overachieving. So these guys are really, really strong. But of course, you prepare for this, you geared up for this. This is what you train for in the different parts of the season, and I'm sure they are ready to represent, and they are ready to do themselves justice by completing this course. Top three up for grabs, team positions up for grabs, but competing is really, really important. As an Olympian, I didn't win it all, but just the fact that I competed and I showed guts and I never gave up was very, very important. It's very, very difficult to beat someone that never gives up. So these young men and young women, these young boys, are definitely giving it their all, and it's quite something to see. And here we see the leader from Central Gauteng Athletics, Neo Motae. He's now well in the lead. He's made his move somewhere. In second place now, 997, Daniel Willemse from Athletics Southwest District. And in the third place, as we get our leader, as we get to see our leader over here, we will just go to the third place under 15 boy, just to see where, under 14 boy, just to see where they are. And you can see that Neo is running barefoot. He's a strong fella. And the bronze medal currently is held by 549 Rico Kutzer. Maybe you will challenge for the silver medal, but we will see. As we see more guys coming in, we see that the winner, the leader, has made his way up. He's going to go around the whiteboard, down the hill, and then on to the finish. Some of the boys are making their way to the finish line. They're making their way as they finish. More or less from here is about 800 meters to go. And then we will be bringing you some of the boys that are still on the route. You can see that they're making their way there. From where you get an angle there, this is more or less 500 or 600 meters. So they are finishing now. This is quite something. So keep your eyes glued so that we can welcome the winner. The winner so far is from Central Gauteng Athletics, Neo Motae, followed by Neo Daniel Willemse from Athletics Southwestern District. And then in third place was from Athletics Gauteng North, Rico Kutsa. So let's see if the order has changed or not. We are going to get ready for the finish, as there is a tape for the winner. I like this gesture by Athletics South Africa. As we can see, the tape is going to be put out for the winner. Look at that. And that way we will be able to get a great shot of the winner. And my bet, I do believe that the winner will be from Central Gauteng Athletics, Neo Motae. 13 minutes for this 4 kilometers unofficially. So let's see what time Neo Motae will run. And it is Neo Motae coming in all alone for the win. 13:24, 13:25 unofficially. Well done, Neo, for the win. Second place was Rico Kutzer. He did go after the silver medal by overtaking Daniel Willemse for the second place. And I'm sure Daniel Willemse will come now in third place, represented by South Athletics Southwestern District. Well done to these boys. The top, The top five will be finished by Athletics Gauteng North. And when I see these boys, I see six or seven, Dante Rath, and then 6-2-1, Tsepang Tsivula. That's the top five, and then they will come in thick and fast to complete the top 10. And while the top 10, top 15 are coming in, I will just give you feed of the middle and the end of the group. From here, like I said, it's more or less 700 meters. They will go around the whiteboard that we saw in the previous shot as they looped. But these boys are running really, really, really well. Here we have them coming in. So congratulations to these gentlemen. And then I'll also show you the feed of some of them that are right at the back, at the end of the pack. They're 145 from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. Is not giving up. He still has that fighting spirit that you saw. And that goes by the name of Rory Trevelvan. So they are running. They are coming in. Congratulations to these boys. They are not giving up. And the action is not stopping. As the boys under 14 are done, we are going to get ready for the girls under 15. As you can see, they're doing their last final bit of warm-up, final checks by the judges. The program today is running on time to the T. We are not wasting any time. So as you can see there, the girls are going to warm up as they go through their final checks. We see a group of athletes praying over there. The provinces, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, Eastern Cape Athletics, Central Gauteng, North Athletics. We see the Vaal Triangle over there. The action is all over there. The provinces are represented. Congratulations, Athletics South Africa, for hosting such an event. If you just joined in with us and you are coming to watch the girls and the boys under 15, please stay tuned to watch the girls and boys. Girls and boys 16, girls and boys 17, as well as the senior women, senior men, and as well as the women under 23 and the men under 23. Tell the people you know to go to the Athletics South Africa webpage, subscribe on YouTube, like, watch. The action is coming very, very fast. We are going to get ready now for the girls under 15, and they will run 4 kilometers.
Oh,
as we are going to move to the girls under 15, I do have some information that majority of the boys are done. I am going to be rectifying this. We are going to move over to the girls under 15, 4 kilometers. My timer will be ready. It will be girls under 15. Do not worry, girls under 15 will be there. As we get ready, girls under 15 is contested by lovely Sting over there, contested by 53. So it's 53 girls. I will have my finger to stop the timer. Like I said, the action is coming thick and fast. So if you're not subscribed and watching notifications on, you will miss the action. So make sure you subscribe, you put on the notifications so that you do not miss the action. Girls under 15, 4 kilometers about to start. Final checks are done. They loop twice. We are here in KwaZulu-Natal, Amanzimtoti, and we are ready to watch these girls run. The wind has picked up, and like I said, for these girls, we have Athletics Central Northwest with 3 athletes, Athletics Free State 5 athletes, Athletics Gauteng North 6, Athletics Mpumalanga 6, Athletics Northwest District 2 athletes, Athletics Southwest District 1 athletes, Athletics Transkei 2 girls, and they are underway. And as I continue, Athletics Vaal Triangle is 4 athletes, Border Athletics only 1 athlete, Central Gauteng Athletics 6 athletes, Eastern Province 2, KwaZulu-Natal, the house favorites, the home favorites, 6 athletes, and concluded with Limpopo Athletics with 6 athletes. And then the last 2 athletes are the Western Province Athletics. The parents are shouting. If you could probably hear from my mic, you can hear the crowd shout for these girls, jotting for position as they want to get the best position, because as they make their way, like I like to call it, the jungle of this course, it becomes narrow, it becomes tricky. So we need to get the best position ever. 53 girls competing over here. Another big group. We had 60 in the previous group. Very large group. It's quite something to watch such a big group running. And as the girls make their way down over there, we can't bring any bike because the course is so tough at that part of the track. A lot of blind spots. They do believe have a very steep section that we now see on camera, where we were able to put a camera. They come up this uphill, from this uphill, and they will go around a whiteboard that you will see eventually when we go there. You will see a whiteboard. They go around. From that whiteboard is more or less 500, 600 meters before they will loop, and then they will do this 2 kilometer loop again, where then they will finish. As you can see, everyone wearing masks, adhering to the COVID regulations. I'm sure the gentleman without a mask has been vaccinated and he's feeling really brave. Here we are, KZN. The sun is shining. It is really good. So we are here in Amanzimtoti. We are in Amanzimtoti. You can see that Athletics South Africa have done a great deal for these for this cross-country competition. You can see the judges and the referees are relaxed. They won't miss any action. This referee might be on her phone, but she will guide the athletes correctly. And then we go back from here, where you will see this is where they will make their way behind the whiteboard that I'm talking about. You will see that whiteboard But until then, they must make their way past this steep, steep, steep uphill. We have officials checking the course constantly. So they're making sure that everything is running super, super smoothly. We see the people are conversing, masks are being worn. Those team members over there from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, I'm sure they've been in contact with one another quite often. So the reason why we see some masks not being worn, but there you can see this referee's got her mask on. This is the last bit of the uphill. So from this uphill, they end on the uphill over here, where they go to a flatter part of the course, which is over here, before they make their way to the white screen. And with that, I will show you when they get over there. But these girls under 15 years old are well underway, and they are going to be coming up the hill really, really shortly. We can see that the lead so far is by Athletics Gauteng North, bib number 511, Wiebke Schoeman, followed by 10005 Abulele Dwachela from Athletics Transkei. You can see also an athlete from 1584, I do believe that is going to be Western Province Athletics, yes, Kiara Besta. She's there in the mix. Athletics Gauteng North in the mix like usual. Central Gauteng Athletics also in the mix. Number 212 is also in the mix, and that's Athletics Central Northwest by Kayla Skeppel. So the lead group, you can see, will go up there, and then they will make their way to the flatter part of the course. As you can see, I don't know if you can hear the people cheering for the athletes, but they do make their way past there, where they will go behind the whiteboard that I was speaking. You can see from that whiteboard is more or less 600 meters, give or take. So these girls are running really, really hard. So as those girls make their way down the hill to the wet part of the track, I'll go back to where they're going down here, where they go from down. So they go up, they have a slight of a downhill, and then they go to a steep hill, and then they make their way over here to this flatter part of the course. And as they're doing that, you can see the route that they are running. There's a little bit of the hill by that officer over there, where she is signaling to the ladies that the route that they must go. And then from there, we will then get feed from where the girls will loop. Remember, they will loop twice. They will run this loop two times as they are running 4 kilometers. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the girls under 15. Girls under 15. And we are live in Amanzimtoti for the national cross country championships. And I don't know if you can see there, far in the back, the girls are coming around to loop. As you can see, they're coming up. That is the wet section of the track. They will go behind the last white board, and then they will make their way to the loop, where they will conclude one loop. So 2 kilometers almost done for these girls. The lead still by 449 Athletics Gauteng North. 449 Athletics Gauteng North is none other by, oh, my papers just flew everywhere. I do apologize, but we do see the Central Gauteng Athletics, Athletics Gauteng North, as they make their way. And then we see the action with these girls. We have the lead here by 10.05 and 12.64. 10.05 is Abulele Duachela from Athletics Transkei, and Central Gauteng Athletics there by 12.64 is Lebo Nyakanyani. So those are the girls in the lead. As you can see, they're making their way. They are running. Some of the girls are still coming in for to finish their loop. We have their number 46 by KwaZulu-Natal, 48, sorry, Kiaran Daidu over there. So they are coming. We do have a lot of runners here by Athletics Vol Triangle. They are in a bunch, 10.71 and 10.90. They are in a bunch. These girls are going at each other. 10.71 and 10.90, that is Marley Dimond, and 10.90, Shanika Rousseau. They are going, they're making their way down into the jungle of this track where they will battle it out. We can see some more runners coming in. We see a lot of athletes from Athletics Mpumalanga coming in to conclude their 2 kilometer loop. A girl here, 963, grabbing some water, very important to hydrate. 963, Shafika Dupree from Athletics Southwestern District. And as you can see, they will be making their way here as they will go down to the jungle of this course, the toughest part of the course. And we can only wish these girls luck, because it is tough. After 2 kilometers, 2 more kilometers to go, is not easy. These girls are making their way down. As they make their way down, we will be getting you then a shot of when they're gonna come up this hill. So they get onto the jungle, from the jungle up that hill, and they go to the jungle part of the track from here. So this is where they funnel out. They really go in single file or maximum two people, as it's quite a steep downhill. But these girls are doing phenomenally well. We can only be proud of them. Top places up for grabs, but also team places. As these girls are going here, they are more than halfway done, because as they go past here, as they go down to the jungle, I do believe that part of the course is maybe 1.7 kilometers to go. Still a while to go, but nevertheless, every inch counts. Inch by inch, centimeter by centimeter, meter by meter, kilometer by kilometer. They will eventually come up over here, but before they do there, I will just show you how you can see the crowd. The crowd is there. The warm-up areas are there. Amazontoti Athletics Club providing the tents for the core rooms for these for the boys under 15 that will be running next. And with these boys running next, we will be glued so that we don't forget to catch the finish for you guys. They will be coming up over here. As we can see, the leader now is making her way up. It's about halfway, I would say. So that is 10.05, Abulele Duachela from Athletics Transkei in the lead, followed by Central Gauteng Athletics 12.64, belonging to Lebo Nkanyani, and then followed by 4.69 Athletics Gauteng North by Izandrik Jacobs. That's your top three, and I do believe that this is not going to change, as the fourth place was quite a little bit behind. Oh, 12.64, 4.69, those are your top three. These girls are really, really brave. Let's see who will make up our top four, our top five, if we can get a shot of those girls. Top four, 12.65 is being held by Ling, we're in Kosi, so we are with these girls. They're over there. Before they make their way over there, we will be filming you as they get over there. You see that the winners are coming as they go around. As they go around that that board, we expect the winner to go down the hill. Not far to go, about 500 meters from here. As she makes her way to there, we are going to be following the girls, because from there we are going to be taken to the finish. As we see the girls, running, quite a view over here. From here they do go to the behind the whiteboard. Like I said, 500 meters, not far to go, and from there we will be getting ready to catch these girls at the finish line. As we're watching these girls coming in, we are going to, like I said, getting ready to watch the girls coming in. The officials usually put out a tape for the girls, which is really, really, really cool. So let's keep our eyes peeled on that. As we can see now here, the girls are more or less going to come for the finish. We are going to get you that shot shortly as we get ready. The officials usually put out the tape. The tape has been put out for these girls. The tape has been put out for these girls, and that is Tenda 005 Abulele Rachela from Athletics Transkei, the winner here in the girls under 15, 4 kilometers, followed by a very fast finish by 469 Athletics Captain North, Izandri Jacobs. And let's see who gets the bronze medal. The bronze medal is going to go to Central Gauteng Athletics with the girl 12.64 by Lebo Kanyani. So Lebo Kanyani getting the third spot, and top four is going to conclude with 12.65 a teammate Lingwe Nkosi, and then top, now the fifth girl coming in is 5.11 Athletics Gauteng North, and that is Vika Skuman. These are the girls that are coming in. We're going to see top 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 coming in now, and as we see these girls coming in, we see some of them that are coming to conclude as they go to the flatter part behind the white screen that I always comment on. And from there it's 500, 600 meters, so not far to go at all. Not far to go at all. So we are here. The girls are coming in. The girls are coming in. We have footage of the girls coming in, and as the girls are coming in, I'm just going to leave you on this feed. As you can see, the girls coming in thick and fast, and we see some of those 500 meters to go over here. These will be coming in 7:10. That is Athletics Mpumalanga 710 goes. Oh, I don't have her registered here. Oh, 710, I do have it. I do apologize. 710 Athletics in Mpumalanga is Carla van Rooyen. She is coming in, and we see these girls coming in.
Well done. What
So as the girls are coming in over here, you can see this was really, really tough. Here we see Athletics in Mpumalanga 665 Athletics in Mpumalanga 665 Athletics in Mpumalanga coming in. It was a tough race for her. 665 goes by the name of Holsthausen. It was really, really tough, but they didn't give up. You can see the officials adhering to the pandemic, sanitizing and making sure everyone is staying aware of the pandemic. As these girls are finishing, you can see over there the boys under 15 are getting ready. And now, remember, I did say that we had a category that was big. The boys under 15 is really, 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 really big. As the girls are finishing, the final check for the boys under 15 is getting underway. As you can see, the judges are speaking to the boys, and this is something nice, just to making sure they're doing the final check. Here are the girls coming in. As the girls are coming in, we will now shift our focus to the boys under 15. With the boys under 15, like I said, there is a category that is very, 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 very big, and this is the category. The boys under 15 have 67 participants. So the start is going to be really, 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 but really, really contested. The position as they make their way down into the jungle, it funnels out. Only two can really go down over there. So getting position is going to be really, but really, really, really important. As we see some of these girls coming in over here, the athlete from Athletics Mpumalanga is going in. The boys are getting ready to start. I forgot to start the timer on the girls, and I apologize. I apologize, and I will make sure that for the boys under 15, it will start. It is picking up with the wind here, but like I said, I cannot. All these names, 67 names, I do not know them well, but I will go by the provinces. Athletics Central Northwest is being represented by 6 athletes. Athletics Free State, 6 athletes. Athletics Gauteng North, 6 athletes. Athletics Mpumalanga, 6 athletes. Athletics Northwest North, 6 athletes. Athletics Southwestern District, 2 athletes. Athletics Transkei, 3. Athletics Vaal Triangle, 4. Boland Athletics. Athletics for these boys is showing a lot of boys here. 4 competitors for Boland Athletics. Central Gauteng Athletics, 6 athletes. Eastern Province Athletics by 2 athletes. The home favorites, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, 6 athletes. Limpopo, 6 athletes. Western Province, 3 athletes. I believe, ladies and gentlemen, this is the biggest field we have had so far, and all the provinces are being represented here, I do believe. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 14, not 14 provinces in South Africa, but they do split in some of the regions. So Western Province does have a couple of regions that will go to Boland, and then some regions also split in the Vaal Triangle. Athletics Transkei also split. Athletics Southwest Districts split as well. The Gauteng Province also splits into Athletics Gauteng North and Central Gauteng Athletics. The Northwest Province also split into Athletics Northwest, Central Northwest and Athletic Central Northwest North. So there are a lot of athletes in this field for the boys under 15, 4 kilometers, 67 participants. This is the biggest field we have had thus far, and I'm going to say that confidently that this is the biggest field that we are going to have through the day. As I page through the list, I see numbers that are falling just short, but nothing is coming close to the number of participants that we have here with the boys, with the boys under 15, 4 kilometers. As we get ready to watch the boys under 15 go, they're getting ready for their final check. Please tell the people at home to log on to YouTube, subscribe to the YouTube page of Athletics South Africa. They must like, subscribe, so that they don't miss any content, any live content that's being put out by Athletics South Africa. Also go to the Athletics South Africa webpage, where you will get the final results. You will get some articles that are being written by the by the media over here in Amanzimtoti at the Athletics South African Championships for the Cross Country 2021. And also, I'm sure that on the Athletics South Africa webpage, you will have a link to watch the ASA National Cross Country Championships 2021 live. So tell the people, make them aware. I heard a whistle. This could mean that the boys under 15 are very, very close to starting. Ladies and gentlemen, we are underway with the boys 4 kilometers. As these boys, as they are underway, I said 67 contenders over here. 67 participants. This is amazing. They are jostling for position. This is going to be quite the show. As we get a view over here for you, you can see that they are already trying to make their way for position. 10 for 7 and 10 for 6 going early in the lead. I do believe that they represent Athletics Transkei. 10 for 7 by Yabonga Nombembe, and then Thabo Nokala 10 for 6. So they have already started quickly, very, very fast, making the way where I say it funnels out. Where it funnels out, they do not run in such a big group, so they need to get to position. They go from here, they go into the jungle of the group, but as you can see, they are making the way. It does funnel out quite a lot. And then we have the last runner here, 1-1-1-3-3-7 by Athletics Central Gauteng Athletics, and that is Pabalo Mutle. So he's the last one, and they will be making their way to the uphill, where we do not have cameras out there, because it's quite a tricky part of the course where not even a camera can go. So they will be running quite a part of the track where it will be quite tricky. Not even we could not even get our bikes out there to live stream that part of the track. But then they do make their way up this hill. From making the way up this hill, we will give you some footage to over here, where we see them coming running flat. From there, we see them going to here where it is the last bit where they go behind the white screen. They go all the way down. As they go down, they go to the wet part of the track. From the wet part of the track, they do come. They will loop. This is a 4 kilometer race. They will loop, and as they loop, then they come past the commentary box here for the final lap. And I must commend, on this day we do see the officials ready. We do see the fans, the parents cheering on. Athletic South Africa has allowed people to watch from the outside. You can get a bit of a view as they are actually looping. And then I also would like to say thank you to all the paramedics that have been here. They have been on call yesterday when it was much, much cooler. They were on call and they were really, really helping out, and they didn't leave anyone behind. This footage over here, from here, it is the uphill. It is the toughest part. So from this camera, they do run uphill, they get a slight downhill, and then they go to a steep uphill, which will lead to here. And then from here, they will then eventually go to here where these men are crossing, where you'll see them come onto the flatter part of the track. And then from here, then they go behind a white screen down the hill to the wet part of the track, where they will be then looping and finishing, and then coming past me. So as we wait here for the boys, we get a shot of them coming up. So I'm sure the leaders have sorted themselves out. Yeah, as we have on the lead, we have 1379. That is Central Gauteng Athletics. 1379, Relebocha Smith. And then from Relebocha Smith, we have 279, I believe. 279 is Central Athletics, Central Northwest. So they are in the numbers. And that man was Amukelang Tatai. He's sticking to the leader. He's not letting the camera go. So we are going to be ready to see the boys coming in. Over here we see a view of that uphill, and then we will see them coming in. The leader here from Central Gauteng Athletics, I did say his name, 1379 Rielebocha Smith. He's making his way, and then as he makes his way, you will see about the white screen that I am talking about. They will go past a white screen where they will loop. They will go down the hill. I saw him going down the hill. He goes down the hill to the tricky part of the course. In that tricky part of the course, it is the wettest part of the course. You can see it is quite steep as these boys are going down. And we get more of a feed over here of these boys coming in where they will be making their way onto that section of the whiteboard, which is more or less 600 to 500 meters before they conclude the 2 meters. I do apologize for this. The wind is picking up, so we will not get such a good footage. But then now we will bring you where the boys are coming to, where they will eventually loop. This is them coming to the end of their first loop, and the lead is still by 1379 Rielebocha Smith, 1379, followed by 1384, the teammate there, Luto Timati, followed by 1327. So far is Oratile Masiho, 1327, 1234 for Central Gauteng Athletics. This is very strong in the boys under 15 category for Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by 587 Athletics Gauteng North. 587 is Samkelo Mbisi. So the boys are running. As we get the feed here, we see that the boys from Central Gauteng Athletics, both barefoot, top three, they are barefoot. They are out here trying to take a clean sweep of the podium. But please do not count out number 587 from Athletics Gauteng North. 587 Athletics Gauteng North also there trying to get the medals. He could snatch a medal. 587 Samkelo Mbise, don't count him out. He's very close to the third placed athlete from Central Gauteng Athletics. These boys are going. The wind has picked up, but there's a lot of movement. The parents are cheering them on. There is quite a view as they make their way for the second loop. They can get a bit of a view of the finish, but they definitely get a very, very good view of the start. And as they're making their way to the funnel, we need to know that is the most difficult part of the race. And then also we also have some of the guys that are finishing their loop. So these guys finishing their loop, we can see that they will go down to the difficult part of the jungle. The wind is picking up and is playing a bit with the transmitters over there. So we just need to make sure we have some good footage for you. So as we go, we will then shift our focus, because most of these boys have gone down to the thick part of the jungle. We will shift our focus for the uphill. But before that, we are going to see the rest of the boys going down for that. And then as they make their way down, we are going to see the parents over here. This is one of the views that I believe they do see. And then here's another view that they do see. This is close to the finish line where they do loop. So from here they do loop, I believe. Now everyone is into the jungle because my camera picks up no one now. So they are in the jungle. And as we wait for them to come up the uphill, you can see over here that everyone is relaxed, waiting for the winners to come. And when I speak about winners, we will be giving you feeds on the cameras, especially also over here. This is the last uphill. I'm actually going to try and get some good footage for you guys so that you can see how steep this is. It is quite steep. The wind has picked up, but the sun is still shining. If the sun is shining, it is much, much, much better. Much, 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 much better. So we go here. We see some of the route. So when I say the people have a view, if you can look right of the screen, just on the top corner, you can see some of the of the parents over there. They get this view. They get this view, and with this view, they are able to cheer. Also over here, this is where they do come for the uphill, and I do believe that we are going to get these boys very shortly. 1379 Central Gauteng Athletics. So Central Gauteng Athletics, that's Rialeboge Smith. He's ahead, followed by his teammate 1327 in bronze, and 1384. So Central Gauteng very strong here. 1384 Luto Timati, and 1384 is Luto Timati, and he's in second place. You can see it goes a little bit down, but Central Gauteng Athletics very, very strong over here. And in the bronze position, we have 1327, and that is Oratile Mashigo. Central Gauteng Athletics over here going for the clean sweep, and I will give you feed from when they come over. As you can see, they come over. They will go over to the start finish line. As you can see over there, they will go behind the white screen. They will go down. As they go down, then it becomes quite tricky. as we can see over here, the leaders have gone. They will be making their way to the finish, but we still have those ones from here. So I guess 1 kilometer to go. I give it 1 kilometer time frame. I didn't measure the course, but from what I see, it is, because as they go past the whiteboard, I know that they have more or less 500 to 600 meters to go. We will be getting ready to give you a feed of the finish. As I give you a feed of the finish, we can see over here that the boys are running up the hill, going behind that whiteboard. And I must say, it is really, really nice from the officials and the idea that they have to put out the tape. And we are going to see the tape over there as they are going to be getting ready to tape. There it is. They will be getting ready to tape. The tape is out. We are going to be getting our winner. Central Gauteng Athletics had the clean sweep. Let's see if it stays like that. If I do remember, it was number 1379 Realeboka Smith that was in the lead, followed by Luto Timati. So let us see. And then Oratile Mashiko in third place. Let us see. It is 1379 Realeboka Smith, followed by 1327 Oratile Mashiko, just pipped his teammate, which was in second place. So 1384 Luto Timati. So Athletics Gauteng North taking the clean sweep, followed by top four there, 426. That is Athletics Athletics Free State. 426 Kotso Sebotsa from Athletics Free State, and then in the top five, 574 from Athletics Gauteng North, 574 Matthews Makwakwa. So he is over there. So this is it. The boys are gonna come in thick and fast. I'll give you some feed of them as they're going to complete the loop. From there, from what I show you, it is more or less 500 to 600 meters, but yeah, it's more or less about 1 kilometer to go. As you can see, the athlete from Eastern Cape Athletics over there coming in for about 1 kilometer to go. You can see that from there the boys are doing great. Yeah, we also have the boys as they are coming in. So as these boys are coming in, I do know that the next, as the action keeps on coming thick and fast, girls under 16 will be running 4 kilometers next. We will be getting ready for that.
From the top. As you can see there, we've got the boys under 15, 4 kilometers. They just finished the race. Now they're just getting the names checked in, and then from there it's about putting on a warm jacket and then getting the mask, getting sanitized. They've also been doing the sanitizing, as you can see over there, making sure that they observe protocol, all protocol observed. It is very important that we respect and you know, respect the rules and regulations when it comes to COVID. So the guys are just making sure that they get sanitized and ready for the race. But coming up now, we've got the girls under 16, 4 kilometers. That race is coming up now. Alright, it's almost time for the girls under 16, 4 kilometers. As you can see, the girls are in their marks, in their position, getting ready to start. Now we're gonna have an interesting race. Let me just run you through some of the names. We've got Ilana Herbst from Athletic Central Northwest. We've got Marks Leon from Athletics Northwest. We've got Kamogelo, also Luanka Van Ons. Van Os from Athletics Central Northwest. And then we've got from Athletics Free State, we've got Yuane De Bray, Alexandra De Klerk, Anne Hayes. As you can see, we are underway. We've got Zandi Leplaiki as well as Donika Azalan from Athletics Free State. And then from Athletics Southern North, we've got the likes of Lee Marie, Decker, Lulu, Mahuba. We've got as well as Pemelo Machaba, Vilmarie Nolte. Chloe Pinar is in here as well as Pablo Khadebe representing AGN. And as you can see, the ladies coming through now. Girls under 16, 4 kilometers. I'll keep on going through the names. At the moment, we've got them coming past us over here in the front. And you can see very strong pack running there. Chloe Pinar running in the colors of AGN. She's one of the athletes to look out for. But there's a lot of athletes. I want to run through all of them. The likes of Tiffany Phillipson. Running in the colors of Athletics in Mpumalanga, Liane Parks, Kutia, Kayla Kutia, as well as Barry Oosthuizen. Sorry, that is Barry Kirsten from Athletics in Mpumalanga, as well as Kaylin Van Donder. And then we've got the likes of Caitlin Ilof, Carla Ferreira, Damian Osik, as well as Kalia. Pence from Athletics Northwest with Mika Van Vieren joining them as well. And then from Athletics Southwestern District, we've got athlete by the name of Mersha Robinson. Athletics Transkei is represented as well by Indipile Dlesi. She's in this one. And then Athletics Val, as the likes of Tineka Blunden, Karabosi Sihloho. We've got Mika Smith as well as Sune Suneiman. Bulland Athletics is represented by Helene Kemp. And then Naledi Makgatha, Gunedi Mashishi is in here. Siho Motsi Sidimo is in here for Central Gauteng Athletics, CGA. As well as Khuputso Shokane, Janelle Stradom, and Ntokozo Tlou in here. Eastern Province is represented by Emma Cruz. And then KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, they've got Aaron Elwood, Samuel Becker, Liandi Dutoit, the likes of Manzi Andile, as well as Beth Mayer from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, as well as Sikakane Sisandra from KZN, the home province. And we also have athletes from Limpopo, Sifaro Kikana, Fiona Makakabe is in here, Matapelo Malachi is here, as well as Rebecca. Rebecca with the surname of McLaren, and then we've got Puti Mukava from Limpopo Athletics, and then finally Western Province Athletics is represented by Annika Fisser. So as you can see, it's a packed race with a total of 51 athletes in this one, and these athletes are going to be looking to fight for that elusive title. It's not easy to win a national title, and once you've got it, you've got it forever. You can always say, I am an SA champion, that is something that you can put on your CV, something that you can talk about for years and years to come. Amazing stories to tell about that. Something that has eluded me as well. I mean, I would have loved to have won a national title. I've only managed some bronze medals as a youth and junior athlete at nationals. Only medaling in gold with the relay teams, but that's what it is. You fight for your life, and you try your best to win the title. And today these young athletes have that opportunity to do so as well. It is the girls under 16 4 kilometers. See, the nice thing about cross country is that they run in their age groups, and everybody gets rewarded according to the age groups. And the under 16 age group category is one of those ones that is highly contested. It's always open, and there's not always a clear favorite. So we'll see how this one will be going. In the past, we've had the likes of Kami Prinsloo, Prudence Sekgodiso, who made this age group category a very tough one. They've obviously moved on to become junior athletes now. And as you can see, now we've got footage from the back there. We call it the jungle, where the athletes are coming through over there. And in the lead at the moment is the athlete from CGA. She goes by the name of, I will get it shortly. I can see that is number 1244. So that is Ntokozo Gumede. Ntokozo Gumede currently in the lead in this race, pushing the pace very strong. She looks very comfortable at the moment. Nice easy stride. She's running with a mask as well. Hey, protocol observed, making sure that she sticks to the regulations, so she can wear the mask immediately after. The wind has picked up again. It's getting a bit chilly again. This is not the Durban we used to. We usually get a phenomenal hot weather in Durban, but as you can see, the winds in Amanzimtoti making it quite a challenge. As you can see, the athlete by the name of Gumede coming through now. She's currently in the lead, running at a ferocious pace, and she's doing very well at the moment. She looks very comfortable for the win in this one, but then again, it's very early, and you do not count your chickens while they hatch. You do not count your apples before you eat them. I'm not sure what that saying is, mixing it up, but you get what I'm saying. Don't catch the chicken if it hasn't hatched. Moving on, it's a beautiful day in Durban. Besides the slight wind and breeze, the sun is shining. We'll take this any day compared to the weather we had yesterday. It was war, and you can see athletes there from Limpopo. We've got athletes from the Free State. Limpopo also represented, and it's good to see because cross country has in the years of past and currently is doing so. It is the sport that develops a lot of the top athletes, especially in the middle distance as well as cross country. So this is something that we're going to be focusing on, and we've had a lot of chats with the president this week as well, in interviews where he just talks about the beauty of the sport, what it has meant for him as well, and how it keeps on contributing to sports or athletics or running in South Africa. So that is currently happening. So as you can see, some of that action at the back, you can see that there's actually even a dam back there. And you're probably thinking, dam? Yes, a dam. There's a dam that is running there. I don't know if the dam is the what they call Amanzi Mtoti. I don't think so, but it is a very interesting dam there. And a lot of scenery there with hills. There's some cobble wood where you have to run over. There's climbs, there's downhills. You can see some of the athletes are prompting to run with finger shoes, sock shoes, instead of running barefoot, just for that a bit of challenging the challenging environment that they get. So we're just trying to see the athletes that are following behind her to do that. And you can see the athletes just trickling in one by one. Very good showing there from these athletes. Let's see how it's gonna pan out. We are 7 minutes and 45 seconds into this one, and a clear lead at the moment. Here we've got Chloe Pienaar. Chloe Pienaar currently pushing the pace on hard in the colors of AGN, but she is not alone. She has the company of a fellow athlete that is currently with her, also from AGN, and they're just making sure that it's a healthy, strong pace in this race. And as more and more athletes are trickling in, it's a very good one. So something very interesting that we find in South Africa is that cross country in South Africa is run in our hotter months, more winter. Besides the leagues, I mean, the championships are usually run in very hot summer conditions, or in the much warmer conditions you find the nationals and so on. If you compare that to countries such as Europe, Poland, all these other European countries, even in the United States of America, cross country is more focus in the winter seasons. And we're talking winter, not winter that we have here, but winter that has snow and it's got rain, and it's miserable. It's almost like Cape Town with a bit more with the temperatures even much more devastating than that. So that's coming up. The athletes just checking their watches. We're 9 minutes at 22 seconds into this 4 kilometer race, so we'll see. Interesting to see what time they will clock on this one. There's some of the athletes coming around for their first loop. It's not easy. It's a very tough course. We saw the men's 10 kilometers was won in a time of 31 and some change. 31 Sbanibani. That was won by Mbuleli Matanga, the man from KZN. A very shy man. He looks forward to running. He does the talking with his legs and not too much with his mouth. But he's a very strong athlete, character as well, that I think we're going to see a lot of him in the future, especially with cross country and road running, as well as track and field in South Africa. Everything just looking positive with regards to middle distance. I think Precious Mashele doing well to open that door as well, having us see a 5,000 meter athlete qualify. It's been a while since seeing Elroy Haaland do it a few years back at the previous Olympics in 2016. If I'm not, yes, 2016. It was good to see the likes of Precious Mashele on a journey, which was an amazing journey towards him qualifying for the next competition and the championships as well. I just look at some of the people in the stands checking their phones. And just keeping up to date with what's happening. Obviously, there's results that are being shared, and people are not allowed into the stadium. They're just trying to keep watching. You can see there's masks. They're trying to social distance the best they can. And that's pretty much what it's like now. Track and field has changed. Cross country has changed. Sport has changed. It's not what we've known it to be, where we just used to interact and mingle. Most of the time, but at the moment you can see that The people are just trying to respect that. But in the lead at the moment, there she is. She has a massive lead amongst against the other athletes that are chasing her. She is Ukumede, looking very strong in this one. And you can see she is not even looking back. Ntokozo Gumede in the colors of Central Gauteng Athletics, CGA, better known as CGA. And this one looks like it's pretty much in the bag, but who knows, maybe something might happen. It is cross country, people fall, people hit walls, anything can happen, but she is looking very strong at the moment. And if I was to put my money on it, I would say she would be taking this one comfortably. And as you can see, there she is over there, Gumede. Currently in the lead, just run about, let's call it 300 meters or a little bit less to go before she finishes off this race. And she doesn't look like she's slowing down. She keeps on just layering the pace, buttering some speed into her legs. And soon she will have a sandwich of a medal around her neck to celebrate. And there she is, that is Gumede coming through for the win, and Ntokozo doing very well to win this one. As you can see, she gets a sanitizer just to make sure that her hands are clean, winning with just on about 14:30 something. Very comfortable lead for her. Nobody is gonna put any pressure on her. And as we wait for the other athletes to come in at the moment, you can just see that some of the athletes are still working their way from the back there. But here in second place is the athlete from AGN coming in for that second place position. And then Central Gauteng coming in for third. And that wraps up the SA championships for the girls under 16 in the 4 kilometers. Well done, ladies. They've done very well. Pushed themselves to the edge in pursuit of honor and to bring pride to their province. Not very easy to do, but they've done a good job. Getting the sanitizer, and then from there on is just getting your number and your place recorded, and it's the end of the championships for these athletes. So they'll be looking forward to trying to either better themselves or defend whatever they've done in the year to come. So it's back to the drawing board, but you know, it's a board that is fulfilling, preparing for championships and being selected to present your province is a very big feat to achieve. And as you can see, these athletes are doing so very well. Vault Triangle, well represented as well, with some athletes getting the job done. And some beautiful shots there from the finish line. Look at that, the pain, the agony. It's tough, it really is. And these athletes are making it just under 17 minutes. And just to bring you, let's just stay at the finish line. You know, it's very good that we see how these athletes are doing. You know, they work so hard. People that are watching at home, you want to see your daughters, your children, your sisters, your friends finishing off what they started, and they've done so very well. And the more and more athletes are coming through for that finish, as you can see there. It's a tough race. You can see it in their faces. You can just see it in their whole body language, like, eesh, what have I gotten myself into? But it is what it is. And you have to show up and you have to do your best. Athletes from KZN representing home ground advantage. Let's see if... not always the case, but for the likes of Mbuleli Matanga, he won the men's 10 kilometers senior race, so it was a case of home ground advantage coming to very good use on his case. But as we spoke earlier with Adam Lipschitz, he said the athletes that tend to come from inland being any country that is not living next to the ocean, where the altitude is much higher, they tend to benefit more from coming down to places like Durban, Cape Town, or even some of the athletes pursue running in Europe to get an advantage of that. So this coming to good use for a lot of these athletes. If you were to look at their watches and look at how they performed on times, I think they would be very pleased. But then again, the discussion is always with cross country, should you use times as the standard for qualification for national teams or provincial teams? I mean, that's a big debate. I've got my own opinion, but it's up to the province or whoever it is to decide. But the biggest discussion or point of argument is that no course is the same. Some courses are super difficult and others can be seen as very easy. So using times to determine the performance is not a viable option most of the time in most cases. So yeah, let's see what we're going to be doing up. Next up, we've got the boys under 16, 6 kilometers. Curtis, you want to run us through the names?
I can, Temba, I can run you through the names, yeah. You are very kind to the guys back home. I usually just rush through these because there's so many names that I don't even go through this. So I do apologize if there are names that I can't pronounce and if there are names that there are numbers over here that do not correspond to that name. I will apologize. My apologies. We have these next five names that I will read out are from Athletics Central Northwest. Rico, Lina, Dino, Nako, Reino, Skita, Andre Spies and Lopang Tikane. They will represent Athletics Central Northwest. Athletics Free State will be represented by six athletes, and they go by the name of Ompilele Tsabo, Amogelang Lobelo, K Kamohelo Mbele Tumisang Mo Le Shononolo Ramatsebe Riatide Ramokopu. I think I need your help, Nadima. This is becoming like a PhD.
Some difficult names. I even get caught out, Kurt, so I don't even blame you.
Thank you, Tema.
So in from Athletics Gauteng North, we've got the likes of Bukang Mabote. We've also got Sifiso Makulu Makwe from Athletics Gauteng North. More athletes from Gauteng North, we've got Sihwata Maropoleng. We've also got Mpumi Mkumbini. We've got Karabo Mutabedi. We've got Johannes Shirindi. And then Athletics Mpumalanga is represented by Zakele, Matebule, Musawo Inkosi, Mnisi, we've got Michael Mukavela, as well as Ruduan Ru, and Sfiso Twala, and Bong Musa Vilakazi from Athletics Mpumalanga. And then from Athletics Northwest, we've got Giandre Berger, we've got Tabang Dipeko, we've got Sean Buikanyo Mutajwa. We've got Bonache Ho, Setole, Caleb Van Rooyen. These athletes are from Athletics Northwest. Athletics Northwest North, apologies about that. ANWN. And then in the colors of Athletics Southwestern District, we've got Lazaro Low, as well as Bonga Mlunguza. From that province. And then Athletics Transcar is represented by Simpiwe Ngwadini. He's in there. And Athletics Val Triangle has Lebohang Mohape, Leslie Mukwena, Simpiwe Mtolo, as well as Lebohang Faldane. And then Borders is represented by Sinolele Ateis. And Central Gauteng Athletics CGA is represented by Ritsepile Fanise. We've got Kevin Hickley, Prince Kilemiti. We've got Johannes Morepi, as well as Tsepo Mbele and Dion van Deventer. So we're getting ready for what is the
boys and the 16.6 kilometer. So we will be getting ready. As they're about to start, I know you are well down the list, so just we'll pause a little bit, then you can carry on with those names, Temba. But we are ready to start with the boys under 16.6 kilometers.
That is correct. We are underway actually, and you can see the boys coming down. This is the floodgates, as I would like to call them, because this is where they all meet up. And they try to get through the passage without bumping, falling, tripping, biting, or getting in each other's way. And at the moment, that's exactly what's happening. There's a clean breakaway. And as we swap to the next camera, you can see over there the athletes using that tunnel to just position themselves into a place where they'll be comfortable with. This group of youngsters are phenomenal runners, distance runners, middle distance runners. And yeah, they're in here trying to give their best in this event. So let's see who's going to be the one who takes out the win and brings it back home.
This one will be interesting. You know, today has been quite a nice day, because, you know, the winners haven't really come from just a central Gauteng Athletics or Athletics Gauteng North. If it's either from them, they take a clean sweep. But we did see a difference in the men's 10 kilometer, and like I say, the boys go down there. That route funnels out into the jungle where we cannot get our cameras. We can't get our cameras because it's quite tricky. Not even a motorbike can go there for us to put a camera. So we apologize for that, and also the blind spots that this course has got. But they do go around that part of the lush jungle that I like to call it, and then they do come up to the feed that you see now. From the feed that you do see now, it's quite uphill, and then they go on a slight downhill, and they go on a very, very steep uphill, and the uphill stops over here. And then our cameras will then follow the boys on what we would call around a white banner down into the The tricky part of the race where it's a course where it is wet, and then from there they come to loop, reminding you guys at home that this is a 6 kilometer race, so they will loop three times. A lot of tactics to play over here, and it's actually very, very nice to see teams are full. Most teams are on a lot of participants, which I heard it is six entries per team, so they are quite full, and it is very, very nice to see.
Yeah, I think it's nice to see, mainly because, I mean, it's at a certain point we, you know, you're always wondering whether the championships will go on, whether we'll be able to run, whether the athletes will be able to, show their talent and represent their provinces, get their provincial colors. I mean, these are all things that are very important, but you never know with COVID. A lot of times things get cancelled and things have to be postponed due to the pandemic. But as you can see, this competition coming through now makes it very exciting. The athletes get to once again run and show their talents to the rest of the country, to their coaches and to their families. And that's what we're focusing on, and that's the aim of these competitions.
Temba, you're right. This is the aim of these competitions. Yes, and as we speak and say, this is the aim of these competitions. I'm glad this competition actually went on, because without this competition going on, I don't know what we would be doing right now. I'm glad that they made a whole lot of space for day one, which is really, really good, and this is really, really good that we are able to be here in Amanzimtoti for the ASA Cross Country Championships 2021. The wind is picking up over here, and it's becoming quite tricky. So we you can see there by the banners blowing that it's quite tough. The boys will be making their way up there. Oh, as the wind picked up, I do not know what happened there with our cameras. I do apologize for that. We will fix it, as they do have two loops. We will get image to you immediately, so we will be ready to give you some footage. Like I said, I will apologize. The transmitters are getting hit hard by the wind. I'm just going stop quickly, just so that I can fix this for you viewers back at home. Are back with one, as we can see. I thought this was very quick, and the lead here is we went back off as the wind was picking up. Oh, now we got it back, but we can see now that it's central it was Central Gauteng Athletics, Mpumalanga Athletics, and then the rest of the pack over there. I do apologize for this a little bit in transmission, but we will be giving you guys the Leaders Athletics in Mpumalanga, Athletics Free State, and Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by the runner there, I do believe it's Athletics Central Northwest North. As they're making their ways here, we can see that no move has been made yet. There is a lead group, there is a middle group, and there is a end group. As you see, the boys are making their way downway to funnel into the thick jungle. So they are making their way to where it funnels. This is the very, very hard part of this track. It is not easy. I will admit this is not easy at all. And I am trying my utmost best to get you guys the feet again. It is very, very, very tricky. I am now able to give you guys the treacherous uphill, the very, very difficult part. As we see this man funneling out, I'll just put the camera to where they go into the uphill. So we are getting back online. We are getting back online. And this is really, really good news. I think I went off there again. Wind is a bit tricky here today, so, but we are trying our best. I do ask you to be a little bit patient. We will be back. So I just want to see if the boys will be able to go up that up this uphill over here. As they go up this uphill, they do make their way around the whiteboard, and I want to give you guys some very, very good footage of this, and we are working on it, so it is coming. As we can see here, the boys are coming in the lead at the moment. It's the athlete from Central Gauteng Athletics 1344 Johannes Morepe, Central Gauteng Athletics, and he's followed closely by his compatriots. So we can expect this to be a tight one, because we will be filming also when they are coming to loop, and I will show you that steep hill that I was talking about as we go on the feed for the for the winners. Now I'll be able to tell you exactly who's in second place, so that we do not disappoint at all. But they will be making their way to that start finish where they'll go loop for the second time before they come for their final lap. boys are more or less halfway. They are coming close to the halfway mark. 12 minutes here, and they are really pushing. If I could try and give you some feed on them coming home, that will be great, so that you can see them trying to get water. My one camera keeps on flicking, but seems like we are back online. As I can see, they'll go on the flat part of the course behind the white buildings, and then they will make their way here to the water station, where this will conclude 4 kilometers. This will be the second loop that they run, and then we still have here the athlete from Central Gauteng Athletics in first place, followed by number 766 from Athletics Mpumalanga, 766 won by Muswa Wenkosi Manisi. Manisi now in second place, and 1344 Central Gauteng Athletics is the current leader. 1344 Johannes Morepe. These two are battling it out for the silver medal, and then we have the contender for bronze, and I could not see his bib number. There we go, 262 if I am not mistaken. So they are fighting it out. These boys are fighting it out, and then coming to close in the top five is Athletics Gauteng North, followed by an athlete from Central Gauteng Athletics, and another one, 242 the Athletics Central Northwest, and I believe that this is the gentleman that is in second place, is also from Central Gauteng Athletics. Could be Dino Nako. I couldn't see his number, but it could be Dino Nako. As we see them coming in for their final lap, we can be assured that they are getting tired. It's past halfway. It's more or less 1.5 kilometers to go from where I believe they are, because as they come here, they will go down, they will funnel, and this will take us to this uphill. And while we are there on this uphill, we still see some of the guys at the water point concluding their 4 kilometers. This is their second loop, and on that we can see the guys that grab the water. They come past here the mobile tent, and we can see that they are running hard. They are not giving up, and you can see them grabbing water very, very frantically. It is warm. It's not cloudy, it's not cold like yesterday. The sun is shining, but nevertheless it is a good day for cross country. Athletics South Africa did their utmost best to host this cross country championship, and so far it is being one hell of a success, if I can put it to you that way. The guys are running. I think they are enjoying it. You can see the boys going down there into the jungle part of the course, as I like to call it. And they will funnel it out before they make their way into the uphill. The uphill that I am referring to is this uphill. As they make their way up this uphill, we might get footage again of the leaders, and the leaders might be yet again the man from Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by Athletics Mpumalanga. So we will have this footage as this man is coming up. Is coming up. Here's the leader. The leader is coming up, and if I'm not mistaken, it is the man with the bib number 1344 from Central Gauteng Athletics. 1344 Johannes Morepe. Johannes Morepe in the lead. He's built quite the lead now. The the gap has grown between him and the athlete in second place from Athletics in Mpumalanga, I do believe it is the athlete by the bib number 766, I believe, and 766 is worn by, oh no, it's 262 that's in second place, and he overtook that man, and 262 is won by Dino Nako from Athletic Central Northwest. And as you can see, the leader goes around that that whiteboard down the hill, as we can see Dino Nako over there making his way up the hill he goes, and you can see, as I say, he goes straight. 766 is also in contention, and that is Mnisi from Athletics in Mpumalanga. And these boys are coming in for the finish. These boys are coming in for the finish, so we need to have you there.
What about me, Nolo?
So all the cameras are fine for Gamma. You are just off.
And as these boys are making their way, I do believe that's more or less 300 meters, and with this 300 meters, I do believe that these guys are ready to finish. Now my finish camera has just gone off, and that is not good news. That is not good news at all. I'll see if I can bring you with this camera. Here's the man coming in for the win on the and there he is. That is the man from Central Gauteng Athletics. The man from Central Gauteng Athletics. It is another win for Central Gauteng Athletics. What I do believe, the guys are going there, the girls are also getting ready. The guys are also coming thick and fast, coming thick and fast for this finish. And you can see there, that's how they are coming in towards the finish line. I do apologize, we've had all day this finish line, and I've lost feet. Like I said, the wind has come up, and it is messing up a little bit with my transmitters. As you can see, the banners over there going thick and fast. As the boys are going there, you see the middle and the end of the groups also still in the running. They are still in the running, so that they can still keep up with that team medals and individual medals, as well as finishing the race, which is really, really, really important. The boys are coming in, and I just got confirmation that Johannes, I think it is Johannes Mokrepi, was the winner of this boys under 16, 6 kilometers. They ran 3 loops of the track, and Johannes Mokrepi, they're the winner for Central Gauteng Athletics. Central Gauteng Athletics, the winner. Trying to get you guys feeds of the guys coming into the finish line. I do not have my camera up there, and these guys are coming in thick and fast, and I'm just giving you a different feed just so that you can see the grit of these guys fighting for that finish. The one dipping, the one right there at the line. I have lost visual on some of my cameras, and I'm getting, so we might be getting a few of the guys coming in, a few of the guys still coming in, and the boys are still coming in onto the finish line.
still off. Back.
This is the girl, 17 years old, 4 kilometer away. Girls, you'll be ready. See you back this afternoon.
Good afternoon. We currently have the 6 kilometer underway now. We're experiencing a bit of transmission problem. Wind has picked up, so we're just currently fixing that. So just bear with us for a bit. We are eagerly and currently just dealing with it. So we'll be back ASAP. So just give us a bit of a time to sort that out. But we will be back. We're just trying to sort out these cameras so that we can have footage. The transmission, as I said, due to the weather has caused a bit of interference. So we will fix that shortly.
Am I back?
You're back.
Zach of Scammer Sauna.
Thank you.
one leg. Come on. Hello. So, Fugama. Camera ya trevo online. Yeah. Camera trevo online. Okay, so. Okay, yeah, so. You have it, so it's good. We'll make on this camera and get it to work. Thank you.
Come on, what will you do?
Are you picking me up?
Thank you. Move it to where? No, no. Move it to where? Key the guy.
Come, they're coming towards you, so just make sure that you're ready.
Oh, too high. Why too high?
Wait, it's too high for you.
Oh, wait, no, I mean, I'm going to... Hey, it was here, but I thought that I really was shocked.
Can you just repeat that?
You told me that it was there, but... You know, we saw what I was saying. Nothing, we didn't avoid that. We didn't. You see, like you can't avoid it. So when it's a bit high, just do it. Maybe who's able to assist anything that comes your way. You don't think so? Try it.
So the yoga and HDMI is going to stay just set up with the kids. Yeah. Oh my god. Oh, just call it here. Are you clear? Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do really, really want to apologize for this inconvenience. Like I said, the weather is going up and down, and then it might not look so here, but when the wind comes with a gust, it's really, really bad. But no excuses from my side. I really do apologize. We will do our best to cover these boys under 17, 6 kilometer running. I do believe they are coming close to the end. As they're coming close to the end, we are already going to gear up for the senior men 4 kilometers, as well as the under 23s also 4 kilometers. So the action is going to be fast towards the end, and we will be right here to bring you all the action. We have the guys coming in. Maybe they coming in for the loop. So we are ready to keep you guys in for the action. They're coming in for the second loop so that they can start the end. So get ready. Here we go. The leader is there from Central Gauteng Athletics, number 1345. Boys under 17, 6 kilometer, 1345 is our leader, and he is from Central Gauteng Athletics. 1345, Moswe in the lead, followed by the home favorite, 113 from KwaZulu Natal, and that is a Siselo Makwanazi. Siselo Makwanazi. As we see those leaders, I'm going to try and give you as much footage as possible. They are making their way for their final loop. They only loop two times, and then they're going to the rough part of the jungle. They are grabbing water. It is getting cooler, so this is playing to the hands of the senior men and women, because they are going to come and run really, really fast. It's not so hot and humid as how it was before. So as we are here, we are bringing you the guys that are coming in, getting water. They are coming in for their last lap. This is a hard one. You can see they are coming. There's Team KZN. 1, 2, 3 from the boys under 17, 6 kilometers. Athletics, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, 1, 2, 3. Asanda Ndaba, they're going into the thick jungle part of the race. And while they go there, we see more guys are coming to get water and make their way through the thick jungle. As they make their way through the thick jungle, I did say there are quite a lot of blind spots. One of the reasons why it took me a while, I was trying to get to different angles, but I was not able to get over there. So I do apologize once again for that loss of transmission in the girls 17 under 17 race. But now we are back here with the boys under 17, 6 kilometers. Boys under 17, 6 kilometers. I'll try and bring you all the action thick and fast. While these guys are coming in for their last lap, we must also keep an eye out, because I'm sure the leaders are going to be coming up quite shortly, I do believe, into the uphill, as they are coming into the uphill, going to the finish line. So as we are waiting for these boys to come up the hill, we can just hope that the leading pack comes up the hill shortly. I do believe we might see one of the runners. Yes, it is. It is the runner from Central Gauteng Athletics, 1345. Runner 1345 is well on his way. That is Moswe from Central Gauteng Athletics. I do apologize if I do not pronunciate the names properly, but he is in the lead. We are going to get another gold medal from Central Gauteng Athletics, and he has quite a gap between him and the second place. This young man also really, really tough, running barefoot. This is real, real talent. This is what ASA Cross Country is all about. And then there in second place is the man from KZN, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, 113, Siselo Makwanazi. Siselo over there chasing Central Gauteng Athletics. As we can see, you see the leader over there. He'll go behind that white board down the hill onto the part of the track where it is quite wet, and it is not so easy to navigate. As we see that, we see some of the runners running on that part of the course, going for their final race, and as we do that, we will be ready to film the finish for the boys under 17 race, 6 kilometer. As we are getting ready for the finish, we can see some of the boys are there coming down the last bit, give or take 1 kilometer. And then, like always, the finish is put out by a tape by the officials. So we will be getting that tape ready. The officials are going to be putting out the tape soon, and while the officials do that, we will be getting ready to witness the winner of this men's under 17, won by I do believe the man from Central Gauteng Athletics. And the man from Central Gauteng Athletics goes by the name of and it is the winner, 1345 Moshwell, Central Gauteng Athletics, the winner of the boys under 17 6 kilometer. As you can see, they're coming in, 1134 KZN, the home favorite, getting the silver medal. 113 KwaZulu Natal Athletics, Siselo Makwanazi over there, look at him doing the dance, he is happy with his performance. And the boys are coming in, top 5, top 6, top 7, top 10, they are all coming. And as these boys are coming in about a minute and a half time, I'm going to end the stream and I will start another stream. This will be the link for the third session. We do the third, the senior woman and the senior men 4 kilometers, followed by the woman under 23 and men under 23 4 kilometer. I'll just keep the cameras here for a little bit longer. As you can see, these young boys under 17 years old crossing the line, and as we are doing this, we will be setting up the second stream link for the third session. So yes, I got the go ahead. Thank you for watching, and I do apologize for that brief interruption on the second session, but we are here in day 2 and we will begin the session 3 very, very shortly. Thank you very much to the ones watching at home.